to another video. I'm so happy you decided to click on today's video because it's a very special video. I am not only sharing with you what I ate for 5 days, just spending $6, but I also have a little bit of a special announcement and I hope you guys will help me out. So for starters, I did spend just $6. I went to my local dollar store. I didn't get anything special when I was shopping. I got 1 pound of black beans, 2 pounds of white rice, 2 bags of frozen broccoli florets, 1 10-ounce bag of frozen blueberries, and 1 pound of oats. That's it. That's all I got. And I decided to create very, very simple meals from those items to feed myself for 5 days. I did not use any pantry staples. I used a little bit of salt to season my food and that was it. I went super, super basic. And the reason I decided to do a really extreme grocery budget meal plan for this week is because I personally wanted to take and stretch my personal grocery budget so that way I could feed and sponsor another family in my community. Now, where I live, it costs $35 a week to donate to sponsor and feed a family of 4 here in my community. And if you've been around my channel for a while, you know that I am being super frugal with my own food budget because my husband and I are on a goal to becoming completely debt-free in the year 2021. However, with that being said, it doesn't mean that we have not been giving back to our local communities. I talk all the time here on my channel that if you need food, make sure to reach out to 211. They're an amazing resource here in the US and they will help direct you if you need food. But we do volunteer at our local food pantry and we do give back. And I decided that if I spent just a little bit less this week, instead of just sponsoring one family into our personal budget, I could sponsor 2. And then I got the great idea that I was hoping you guys would all help me out here on YouTube within my community and afar. If you would please give this video a like, comment down below, and even share this on your social media platform. What I'm hoping to do with today's video is take the AdSense generated and donate it to my local food pantry and hopefully feed at least 10 families. That is my goal. My goal is 10 families, so I really need your help. Like, comment, share, because it's not just me. I'm using my voice and my platform to give back to my community, but I need help from all of you to generate more views so that way we can feed more people. We all know that food insecurity is a huge thing, not only in the US, but all over the country. And we need to start with our communities first and we need to give back. If you are in a position to give back, I highly, highly encourage you to do so. Even if you just sponsor 1 family a month or every other month, if you are someone who can do that, I really encourage it. If you are someone that needs food, and you clicked on this video, I hope that you call 211, reach out to your local churches, schools, or even food pantries. A quick Google search will give you means and resources in your area to feed your family. Do not go without. I hope you already smashed that thumbs up button, but let's jump in and I'll show you what I ate for the past 5 days. These meals are extremely, extremely simple, but they are also very nutritious. I tried to get the most nutritious foods when it came to spending the least amount of money. So this bag of oats is actually 11 servings, but I split it into 5. So that's a pretty generous serving. And then I had some frozen blueberries, so I had some really good whole grains and some antioxidants, some fruit, and I just put water with mine. The only other condiment I used all week was salt. So I do like to microwave my oatmeal. It's just a personal preference, but you could cook this on the stovetop as well. And I also like very little water with it, but if you like more water, you could amp it up and use more water. But this is a very, very filling and nutritious breakfast. I did have to do a little tiny bit of meal prep when it comes to these meals, just because I wanted to work ahead for the week. I roasted my broccoli, and as you can see, it's not just florets, it is a little bit of the stems as well, but broccoli is super nutritious. You get a ton of vitamins, a ton of fiber, and even protein. So I did pick broccoli just because of how nutritious it was, and I just roasted it in my oven. I didn't use anything fancy when it came to cooking my food this week. I just went the simplest route possible because it wasn't really about the meals, it was about how I could give back. So I did split my broccoli florets with the ends, and what I decided to do with the ends is add them to some of my beans. And I did keep the bean liquor in there as well, just for added nutrients. But beans are great for fiber and for protein, and then you have a lot of rice that you can really bulk up your food and get a lot of energy for those carbs. So I added rice, black beans, and some of this broccoli stems into a bowl and kind of tried to mash it together. I could have pulled out my food processor, but I decided not to. And I tried to attempt to make a black bean burger. It wasn't very successful. So this evening, I actually ended up just kind of tossing it around in the pan and making kind of a crispy rice, which I really, really like. Just kind of take some of that moisture out and it's just really good. It's almost like a fried rice. And then the next evening, I actually decided to take the same mixture and put it into a little mini muffin tin. and bake it into my oven. Again, I could use my food processor and just made meatballs, but this was just a simple way to do so. And it was really, really easy. And then the last meal that I rotated between lunch and dinner with the meatballs that I made was just a really simple broccoli and beans and rice. And I had so much beans and rice that this was actually a really good staple meal for the week. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you know how much I appreciate you viewing this video, giving it a thumbs up, hopefully commenting, and even sharing this video. Tag me over on Instagram if you do share it so I can personally thank you for helping me feed the people in my community. This is a group effort. It's just not me. I am just using my voice, and I'm really needing you all to help me feed the people in my community. We all know food insecurity is such a big thing all over the world, not just in our own personal communities, but I think when you are more aware of it, you can do better, and that's what I want to personally do. I want to use my channel to serve and help the people that really need it. And I try to do so with my extreme grocery budget hauls. I try to share with you frugal meal ideas if you are someone who is trying to reach financial freedom like myself, or maybe you just want to free up some cash flow so that you can generate more giving to your local community like I want to do. I hope you enjoyed the meals today. Like I said, they were super basic, but when putting this video together, I really tried to think of the most nutritious, inexpensive meals that I could find. And for me personally, I know that the dollar store in my area is one of the best finds when it comes to a lot of cheap, inexpensive foods. And I know that I can spend very little and get a lot of food, like 2 pounds of rice for a dollar. That is a good amount of calories that will feed me for a good chunk of the week. Same with beans. I try to think of fiber and protein and good nutrients. Broccoli gave me my calcium and my fiber and my vegetable. I even had a fruit with blueberries having some antioxidants, and I had a whole grain with my oats. So I really tried to think outside of the box, but also keep it very, very simple. I didn't add any condiments or seasonings because I just wanted to share with you not only the basics, but just to say, hey, this is the food that I ate for 5 days. But if you recreate any of these meals, you could definitely add condiments if you have them on hand, but if not, they're perfect just as they are. I cannot thank you enough for watching today's video. I hope that you enjoyed just this different type of video that I am sharing, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.